Hello. I live in Australia and the government here has recently released a contact tracing app called COVIDSafe. There has been a lot of chatter about how this doesn't work properly on Apple phones. That is kind of true, but there is also a lot of misinformation flying around. It's very frustrating to read. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how this works. Against my better judgment, I have installed the government app on my iPhone so we can do some experiments with it. I also have an iPad where I have installed a custom application that I wrote. This custom app will show me the Bluetooth broadcasts and also let me interrogate the COVIDSafe app to retrieve the encrypted key. I'm not going to try to explain everything. What I'm hoping you'll see is that it kind of works, but it also kind of doesn't. Let's start with the basics. Here is my phone. It is running the COVIDSafe app, as you can see. And over here, I'm running the test app on my iPad. If I look at the debugger output, you can see that it's receiving a lot of advertisements. You can see the seconds ticking up there. I'm getting about 20 or 30 advertisements per second from the COVIDSafe app at the moment. That long hexadecimal number starting with 29 identifies the COVIDSafe app. So you can see these are flying past pretty quickly at the moment. Let's now put that app into the background. I'm not sure how obvious this is, but these lines of text are being produced much more slowly now. We're only getting, you know, a few a second, something like that. So the app is still actually broadcasting, even though it's not in the foreground, but it's a fair bit slower. Next, let's actually lock the device. I'm going to press this button over here and it's completely off with its screen now. You can see that we're still getting a trickle of advertisements. So the COVIDSafe app is definitely registered for Bluetooth advertising in the background. And when it is in the background, it is transmitting. It's just transmitting at a lower rate than before. Now, it's important to realize that none of this information in the Bluetooth broadcast actually identifies you. This advertisement is merely saying, hello, I'm a phone that is running the COVIDSafe app. To get the encrypted key, which identifies the owner of a phone, we actually have to establish a connection to that phone over Bluetooth and submit a special request to read data. Now, I have built that feature into my test app. As you can see, it's extremely fancy. I have a button there called Interrogate. If I tap on that, it will connect to the phone and read that information out of the COVIDSafe app. So my phone running the app is still locked, but let's have a look at the debugger and I will tap on that interrogate button now and we'll see what happens. There we go. So it managed to connect and it managed to receive the encrypted message identifying my phone from the iPhone, even though the iPhone is locked. So far, this looks pretty good, right? The catch is that so far, the test app on my iPad has always been in the foreground. If the iPhone is locked and slows down its Bluetooth, it doesn't really matter. But if the iPad and the iPhone are both locked and they both slow down their Bluetooth at the same time, they can end up missing each other. That's when the COVIDSafe app doesn't necessarily work properly. I'm going to try to show that to you now. You can see both devices are currently unlocked. They're in the foreground and we have a steady stream of advertisements coming through. First, I will lock the iPhone and that will slow down the stream like before. Next, I will also lock the iPad. And the stream of advertisements will stop entirely. We're not receiving them anymore. And this is the fundamental problem here. Now I'm going to bring up my iPhone and I'm going to unlock it. And as soon as I did, would you look at that? We received a single advertisement. So it allocated more power to the Bluetooth and my locked iPad was able to receive an advertisement. I can't press the interrogate button because it's locked, but in practice, having received this line, my app could connect to the phone and retrieve the COVIDSafe ID all while the iPad is locked. So you can see that iOS devices also have the ability to do Bluetooth scanning in the background. But all is not well. Do you notice how we only ever got one line there? Well, that's another iOS restriction. If you're scanning for Bluetooth devices and you're in the background, like we are here, iOS will only ever give you the first advertisement for a particular device. If your app wants to know whether you spent 15 minutes with someone, this is not very useful. In conclusion, this doesn't work. Unless at least one person has their phone unlocked, it's not going to do what it's supposed to do. That's why it's so important that the government moves to this new framework created by Apple and Google that will resolve these problems and also protect our privacy better. I can only hope that this will clear up some of the confusion on this topic. Until next time, cheerio.